Perfect. Your boy One Killer Cat back at it again with another video. Let's get it. Y'all can see I'm in the Hellcat, man. I'm headed up to the dealership. I ain't even gonna BS y'all, man. I'm contemplating trading in the Hellcat. They called me again, so I'm not even gonna BS you on the video and make y'all guess. They called me, told me they got a Trackhawk up there. We're going to go up there and see what the prices is and everything, what the numbers are. They already told me they want $85 for it. And I was like, it's a 2018. It got 40,000 miles on it. But it is the top of the line, got the TVs and everything in the back. So I've been finding 2018s with about the same amount of mileage on them for about 77. So I told him, I was like, hey, if you take it to 77, give me 66 for mine, like we talked about before, I'll trade mine in and I'll come pick it up. I'll leave mine as it is, as it sits, rims and all. There's only a couple things that I'll actually take out of my Hellcat that I can put in the Trackhawk. Basically day one, I'll probably remove my subs, my sub box and my subs. Take all of that out, throw it in the Trackhawk. Cause then I'll be able to put my stroller on top of the sub box when I need to. Other than that, I'm like, we'll see. I already told him, don't BS me. Y'all know how I am. Y'all know how I get. Do not work my nerves trying to work a deal. They already said they want to look at it again and that they'll make my offer. But I'm like, hey, do not BS me, man. Don't waste my time, because I'm at home with my daughter, and I already told him, like, hey, I'm not doing this whole giving my keys a thousand time thing again. If y'all didn't already see that video, y'all know how I am when I get in the dealership. I don't play those games. I'm serious. Like, I want good quality work on my cars. I want a good price. I'm about you making your money as well, but I'm about not getting ripped off and, you know, in this market, buying a Trackhawk or a Hellcat or a Scat Pack is crazy right now. Everybody says wait. But the good thing about a Trackhawk is at 77, that's not a bad deal. Like, the one that I was going to buy brand new was 96. And I was like, I don't know if I want to do that 96 racks. Woo! So the fact that I could buy this one and it's used 2018, so I'm going from an 18 to an 18 and pay 77, get 16, 17 racks off of mine. I'm right at like $50,000 on mine. Put down probably about 10 racks. So 77, get it down to 67. Cause I told him 77 out the door. So 77 out the door, put down 10, keep a little bit, you know, start modding. Not a bad deal. I could get it a little bit lower if I really wanted to. So we'll see. Because I'm not trying to be crazy. I got a daughter. I need to make sure that everything's good with her and keep my car good. So we're going to see. I'm going to cut this camera back on. We get up to the dealership, see what they talking about once again, and see if we leave with a Trackhawk, you know. Hold on real quick, guys. I don't know if y'all can see this. This is the Wagoneer right here. You see the price on it. They go to baseball. It's almost better to buy the Wagoneer. Like, the Trackhawk looks better, of course, to me. All right, bro. The Wagoneer doesn't look as good, of course, as the Jeep Grand Cherokee to me, but that's because one is sports and one is more luxury. But the price on this is better than the price of buying a used Trackhawk. This was brand new, 76, and I don't know if y'all ever looked up the Wagoneer. I'm talking about luxury. Big screen in there, and then there's a screen on the other side, right above the glove compartment. I got a full screen over there. Like, that thing is legit, legit. Like, this thing is crazy. It's a 5.7, but at this point in time, I'm not buying it for the engine. You're buying it for the luxury of the vehicle and all the aspects that it can do. It's like the luxury Jeep. They made this, and then they didn't put Jeep on it anywhere. It says Wagoneer everywhere. It doesn't say Jeep on it nowhere. That's one thing that they did when they made these. This thing is sharp. Like, it looks really good. So it almost make more sense to buy this versus buying a Trackhawk. Now, I wouldn't buy this to stay on YouTube. If I was gonna buy this, this would be to, for me, just for the family. And I probably wouldn't be doing a YouTube thing. The Trackhawk, I could still do YouTube content. I mean, I could do YouTube content with this, but it wouldn't be the same. It'd be basically starting over. I looked at this one over here. That's not the one I was looking at, but it is beautiful. You know how I like that color, especially since I had mine and put the gold on there. Oh my goodness. A Trackhawk in this color with my gold accents, ooh, be fire. This is a V6 right here though. All right, guys, we up at the Dallas dealership that actually has the Trackhawk. So here it is behind me right there. Yeah, she's a beauty. So we're gonna walk around right quick, look at her, because I do want her. We've been talking in the car on the ride over here. This thing looks good. It's just the numbers. The only thing that's keeping me from buying this car. If the numbers come out right, I will buy this car. Like, I'm gonna do it. If the numbers come out correctly, let's see. Yeah, she's pretty. Trying to figure out right now what I would do. What would I do to the Trackhawk? The wheels are gonna change, of course. I love the quad tips back here. Tinted tail lights, got the Jeep. Yellow Brembos, blue. Like, yeah, she's beautiful. Let me see. Windows are tinted, so I don't gotta do that. That's always a plus. Can I open her up? Can I open her up? Cloth interior. Got the TV screens in the back. 40,000 miles, it's not bad. TVs in the back for the kids. You know, I got the kiddos, so I need that. Need that. Moonroof. Yeah. Oh yeah, I'm loving it. Gotta hit the push. Yeah, got the full in the back. I need that. Let's pop this hood. Oh, that's crazy. Well, they got me out here popping the hood on somebody else's car already. I guess it sold before I could get here. Dang, that sucks. Well, I guess I'm not getting the Trackhawk today. Had the JLT. That's what's up. Man, I was too late. My man Quez brought me out here.
I tried.
And we was too late. Like, they said dude was in the dealership in finance right now. Hey, it was nice. It was nice. I was like, I'm already thinking, like, what am I going to do to it? The wheels, all that good jazz. We just kind of, you know, went through the numbers. Oh, buddy tripping. Dude. Buddy pulled out in front of his little John Deere thing. Yeah, we getting on the highway. But, yeah. They said they do saw it and came in at, like, 9 o'clock this morning. I guess he's just now getting the deal. But they said he in finance. Picking it up. I'm over here opening up the compartments and
the trunk.
Yeah, I opened up every single thing. I'm in there looking at it. I'm like, yo, if it ain't got a sold sticker on it, I'm opening it up. But yeah, it was just a little bit too late. So, I told my girl before I came out here, I said, I pray to God that I get a deal that I can't walk away from. So we'll see if maybe that happens later on. Maybe I catch a better deal because they was going to work this one. So they already know what I kind of want, what I'm looking for. So maybe the next one will come in and we'll work a better deal on the next one. But I ain't even going to BS y'all. That's what, in the beginning of my video, I really didn't know that this car sold yet because I wouldn't have came out. But yeah, it sold right when we got here, so we didn't get to actually go buy it, because I was real life like, all right, I may go get some stock tires and throw the wide body wheels on, take my rims off and just sell them. Like, I'm over here really contemplating, like, all right, I need to take the sound system, my subs out, the rest of the sound system they was gonna get the highs and the amps for the highs and all that type of stuff, get the lights, because you know I'm not taking the lights off, so it was about to be what it was. But oh well, that's gonna be it for this video. No, I did not buy a Trackhawk. I really wish I could have, but it sold before we got here. Man. All right, real quick before I end this video, I am back in the Hellcat, man. I was kind of disappointed. Like, not even gonna say kind of, I really was disappointed, because when I went there, just to give y'all a little bit more, they had already said, because the car was at a different dealership, they needed to run the numbers and make sure that they were gonna give me what I wanted for my car and give me what I wanted for that one. So that was already said, because with these cars, you can't go in and just test drive these cars without being approved or knowing that you're gonna buy it. Like, they see that I have a Hellcat, so they know that, like, I drive these cars, and then can I afford it? So that was the thing about it. So before we even left our dealership, without them running my credit, we had already came up with the, hey, we're going to work the deal. These are the numbers that you wanted. We're going to work the deal. So you can go over to that dealership and go see if you actually like the car, test drive it, make sure that there's nothing wrong with it, and then come back. We'll sign all the paperwork and go get it. Because they didn't want to leave the price at $85,000. I find out, bro, I'm not giving y'all $85,000. And I done went over there and test drove the car and everything, or trying to test drive the car, and we never even worked on the numbers. So we got the numbers basically squared away ahead of time and was like, hey, like, we'll get you all the further information, but no, we'll give you the 66, we'll send you a car, we'll sell you that one for 77. Do you like it? Go test drive it. You like it? Come back. Let's do the paperwork. So that's where we were at. And as long as there was nothing wrong with it when I test drive it, I was buying a Trackhawk today. We were going to have a video of me buying a Trackhawk, is what was just about to happen. So I'm real life bummed about it, because, like, I love my Hellcat. Like, I've modded it to all ends, and I still actually have mods that I can do to the Hellcat, but I wanted to start over with something that I can have the family in and them enjoy and be comfortable in, you know, and be able to still do the same stuff. I don't like losing the quality of stuff, because the thing about my Hellcat is I'm getting ready to rip my subs out, put a 110 back there, so it's some loss, so I can still have a little bit of bass, but I can put the car seat in the back, so at any point in time when I'm taking my daughter around, I can have the stroller, not the car seat in the back, but the stroller in the trunk, so that I can ride her around in her stroller, no problem whatsoever. I don't have to worry. Let me go get the stroller from upstairs. Let me create room in the back seat so I can put the stroller in. You know, none of that. Throw the stroller in the trunk, keep on going. So with the Trackhawk, that allows me to put the stroller just right on top of the sub box and keep it moving. Just, you know, put it up there and keep on going and ride around. Still have my subs in there, have my Bang. The Bang would have hit a lot harder in the Trackhawk than it does in there, because the Bang would have been inside of the cab. So it was just going to be crazy. I could already see, like, I was already looking like, oh, y'all think that I did some crazy stuff to this Hellcat? Wait till I get my Trackhawk. I'm going to do it. I'm not as big as these other YouTubers. All this stuff comes out of my money. YouTube does, I am monetized by YouTube. But I haven't got enough people watching the commercials for me to get paid yet. So if you've made it to this spot of the video, man, share my video. If you want to see me do some more content and everything, we got to get this YouTube algorithm up. It's hard for YouTubers right now. People aren't watching the content and people's views are going down. And I'm a small YouTuber. So if y'all want to see what I can do to a track hog, to a TRX type of stuff, I need y'all to subscribe to my channel, man. Real life, like the videos, share my stuff, man. I'm trying to be out there like the greats, man. I'm watching great YouTubers like that are dropping off, and I'm steady trying to do it from the bottom. And it's been a little bit of me, you know, slacking around. I'm sorry this end of this video is so long, but like, this is the real life truth, man. It's been a little while since I shot a YouTube video because it's getting hard to want to do the content when you're not getting the views that you feel like you put into the work. And then I got my daughter. I have my daughter all the time. I got my 9-year-old and my newborn. And it's hard to go out and shoot a video and feel like, oh yeah, I'm shooting a video to, you know, to help people out and get these views and get paid for it when you're not getting a lot of views. So once again, man, if you made it to this spot in the video, go ahead and hit the like button, man. I'm going to keep y'all up on game. I'm going to keep on modifying these vehicles. As soon as I got that track hawk, y'all already know, Lighting Trends, I was going to hit them up. I was going to get all my lights, and we was about to install the full underglow headlights. All that good jazz. We would have did an install video. Starlight ceiling probably would have went in. A whole bunch of stuff automatically. Like, I would have ordered so much of that stuff. If I had bought my track hawk today, I would have ordered my light setup today. Had it express shipped here. Had it by Friday. Saturday, we'd have been shooting a video. And I promise you, Monday and Tuesday and next week, there would have been a whole track hawk video of the install of some lights. Let alone, I still would have had videos of, you know, picking up my Hellcat or first driving, driving the Trackhawk, all that good jazz, man. So be prepared. The content is coming. I just need y'all help on doing the simple free stuff. Like, comment, subscribe. The thing keep going around TikTok. Why you not famous yet? Why you not famous yet? Because you ain't shared my stuff. I'm not famous because you ain't shared my stuff. Why haven't you shared it yet? Let's get it.